People are getting creative to help healthcare workers on the front lines.
WGN's Julie Unruh shows us one CPS teacher working from home using his computer science background to come up with something new, something innovative, something needed.
Jeff Solon created a National Institutes of Health approved face shield for healthcare workers. It's made from one material that comes in one piece and can be shipped directly to a hospital in bulk. It's easy to assemble and easy to sterilize, I'm told. Here's the best part. It doesn't cost anyone a red cent. The face shield is free. Only one problem, however. There's been a run on the plastic that it's made from.
You know, given the current climate, this is absolutely a game changer because it means that we're getting, you know, supplies to the front line at a volume that we previously didn't have.
That is Dr. Juan Alban during a break from the medical ICU at a prestigious Chicago hospital. So he's keeping his mask on his face while we talk. There, sick patients who could have coronavirus see doctors like him first. Having the right gear to protect him, forever a concern. Enter Jeff Solon, a computer science teacher at a Chicago public high school stuck at home, teaching from his couch during the shelter-in-place order.
I designed and built and run a digital fabrication lab at Lane Tech High School so that I can help teach students how to solve problems with their hands and use digital tools available to solve bigger problems.
Practicing what he preaches during the pandemic, Solon came up with this, and in short order, the Solon Flat Pack Face Shield. One piece of PETG plastic, laser cut to NIH specifications in lightning speed, putting 3D printers to shame, he says. He did it with the help of the Illinois PPE Network. There, he was connected with like-minded individuals after the same goal, people like Dr. Alban. Alban on call tested his prototype, asking a dozen or more nurses and doctors to try it too.
I put my first version together, got it off to them, and then got feedback to find out if this was a viable solution or not.
Solon found it was viable all right, just needed a few changes.
As quick as possible, implemented those changes from version 1 to version 8 in less than a week.
But what's really kind of touched me and touched a lot of my colleagues is seeing how hard people are working from home to try to make our jobs easier on a day-to-day basis.
The first batch rolls off of a Minnesota assembly line in a matter of days and heads straight to the city of Chicago for distribution through the Illinois PPE Network, where anyone, like Solon, who wants to do something during the pandemic, can either ask for PPE, help make it, or donate to fund more PPE.
It's all volunteer. It's all people working hard and not making a penny off of it. And so until somebody says, we're good here, we need other things, we're going to keep making the stuff that we can make.
Right now, 8,000 masks are currently in production, but the players involved here have the capacity to make more if only they could get more plastic to make them. Again, PETG plastic specifically. It has to be in the 0.02 to 0.03 inch range. And if they get the supplies, I'm told manufacturers can produce upwards of 2,000 face shields an hour. For more information, head to our website, WGNTV.com. Julie Unruh, WGN News.